So building a business requires, we believe, 5 conditions, and we talk about these conditions in our research. We picked 150 companies. We put $50,000 in each company. In return, they gave us 4 years of their lives. We could study and watch, and we could see decisions through the whole process. But we needed Gallup to take that qualitative work and give it a quantitative wrapper. So what the assessment does for us is it allows me to actually look at your business across the 30 flows that we look at, and I can compare your business to the high-performance benchmark that Gallup built for us.
When he came to us with that framework of what he had observed in the businesses, how did they function, what kind of systems and processes they had in place, and what were the behaviors of the individuals running those businesses, that gave us the foundation of building that assessment. When these kind of research projects are done, and these kinds of assessments are put together, it allows the businesses or the entrepreneurs, the outside world, to actually look at it and say, you know, I have been thinking about it. There was no way for me to identify where is it that my business was lacking.
One of the things we learned from this research is that the startups or the pre-startups are the ones that everyone chases after. Everyone looks at those things. Everyone, they're the skyrockets. They're going 100-to-1. They're the big revenue producers, and they're the exciting ones. What this research shows us is that post-startup companies, the ones that are out there, are kind of the lost leader. They're the lone wolf out there. And what this research shows us is those people stuck in that space could create thousands and thousands of jobs. They could do so much more for the community to help people. And it's given us 5 criteria that now we have some hard data to say, what is your sustainability? Do you have endurance? Is it predictable? What can happen? How are you aligned? And I think those kind of things would really help to grow the marketplace.
We're an application-based incubator, so we can use these benchmarks as part of our application interview process as we're reviewing candidates to make sure that they are poised for growth and scale. So putting all of these systems and processes in place to be able to help them achieve scale, not just incremental growth, to push them through the mid-market phase, which is really a happy and exciting time for us to have these companies hit a headcount point, a revenue point, where they're actually growing out of our space, and then become contributing members of our community back again. So we can use this through all the different levels and types of companies that we work with, and it's applicable across a variety of different industries, which is really important to us as well.
The reason I really appreciate this body of work is that it focuses exactly in the right space. As the head of the USSBA for a few years, what I learned is that there are different types of entrepreneurs. There are some of us that sort of enter entrepreneurship as hobbyists. And then, of course, we have the large corporations. So it's a barbell, right? It's like these two exist. But it's the middle part that is actually the job creator, that handle part, that is the part that we need to focus on. And I said it a million times, that 2/3 of America's job growth comes from this sector. And so to the extent that we can continue to focus on this in a real disciplined way, it was a very scientific approach that can be replicated over and over again. And that's exciting. And so I think that what is happening here is a really important contribution to entrepreneurship.